name is Jay Mitra. I'm Professor of Business Enterprise and Innovation at the University of Essex in the United Kingdom. I've been coming here to Colombia, to Bogota, and to Extremadura University for the last 5-6 years now. And each year I've been presenting a topic, a lecture, and a seminar series at a conference, and also for students as part of the seminar series on a theme centered around business development, entrepreneurship, and innovation. And the reason why I'm here this year is because at the conference I gave a talk on transnational entrepreneurship, and for the seminar series I'm doing several sessions on networks and networking. To me, and I think it has been proven over a period of time, that one of the most interesting and particularly important topics in international business and in international entrepreneurship is the role of transnational entrepreneurs. These are a particular group of entrepreneurs who move away from their home country or their country of origin and adopt another country where they go to live and work, but who also retain very strong ties with their homeland, both in economic terms and in social terms. And through that process, through networking with different players, different social actors, businesses, organizations, institutions, are able to perform economic activity, whether that be in employment, but mainly in business, at both their adopted countries and back in their homeland. So they are part of a community of people who haven't really left home, but have rather created two homes. Or in some cases, especially when it comes to the African community, they have created multiple homes, because their view of homeland is not just the country of origin, but the whole of the continent. And to give you examples of some of the most successful groups of transnational entrepreneurs, they mainly have come from the Jewish communities, from the Armenian communities, and latterly, in recent times, more from the Chinese communities and the Indian communities. These are people who have created homes and workplaces, both in their home country, the country of origin, and also in their adopted countries. And the reason why that is particularly important is because they provide opportunities, not just for themselves, but also for other people, both from their own countries and in the adopted countries, to get together and do more business together as part of the global networking scene. And in today's environment, in today's very globally connected business environment, economic environment, this is an absolute essential for the purposes of doing effective business activity. So that is what I spoke at the conference about, with giving examples and my research that I've carried out on the subject, with particular reference to transnational entrepreneurs in the UK from different communities. The seminar series is on networks and networking, a related subject, perhaps one of the most fundamental issues that affect how people behave, how people interact with each other, for the purposes of generating business and economic opportunity, both for themselves and indeed for other people with whom they work. Networks and networking are not often understood because they constitute something which is a social affair. And by and large, when we talk about businesses, we are talking primarily about the economics of business, the profits, the turnovers, the gains that are made, the employment opportunities, the new products. But how do these things happen? And one of the ways in which things happen is when people know how to trade, how to improve their ability to trade, how to improve their capacity to operate more effectively in the marketplace. And you can't just do that through pure economic means. You have to combine social activity together with economic activity. And if you do the two effectively, the only way you can do it is through networks, joining existing networks of people, and networking with people within particular networks. So my objective in the seminar series is to talk to students about how networks are formed, what do they represent, the different types of networks, that are available in the world and how they contribute to better economic and business development. But my major objective is also to enable some of these students to develop networks for themselves. So there's not much point in just telling them about networks unless you can also encourage them to improve their capacity and their capabilities for networking and thence their own economic and business development. So that's the reason why I'm here, and that's the reason why I hope I will have a reasonably good time with them starting from today.